Mr. President, we find ourselves in the unusual posture of being stuck on a piece of legislation that had 12 Democratic co-sponsors and was supported unanimously by all Republicans and all Democrats on the Senate Judiciary Committee, and which uncharacteristically was brought to the floor without having to jump through the regular procedural hoops that legislation usually has to jump through. And that requires consent by all 100 senators. So when you think about combating human trafficking, and particularly the targeting of 12 to 14-year-old girls who are the typical ages and gender of the people who are victims of human trafficking, you would think that if there's anything that ought to be able to avoid the partisan wars here in Washington, D.C., and the divisions of our that seem to separate us, it ought to be the subject of human trafficking. Well, I guess to say I was disappointed is an understatement, but I'm determined to keep our focus on the victims of human trafficking, the people this would help rescue and help heal and get on with their lives. And yes, I'm also determined to make sure that we can demonstrate we can function, something that I thought senators wanted to do. You know, after this last election, there were a number of people who said, gee, we'd really like to try to change the Senate to restore its reputation as the world's greatest deliberative body, where we actually treasured and valued solutions more than we did scoring partisan political points. Well, Mr. President, I come here today in the spirit of trying to offer a solution that will help us get unstuck from where we have found ourselves. And I happen to see my friend, the Senator from Maine here, who's been working tirelessly to try to help us get unstuck. Perhaps this will help. So just to recap, the way this bill was structured is it would deal with the demand side of human trafficking. In other words, it would take the fines and penalties from the people who purchase these services, and it would create a crime victims compensation fund, which in essence then would be used to help provide the money to faith-based and other organizations that help rescue and help heal these victims of human trafficking. But then we heard from some of our colleagues on the other side that they wanted to change the way this was structured so that it was subject to the routine appropriations process and didn't enlarge the way that the traditional limitations on appropriations were treated under the so-called Hyde Amendment. Just to refresh everybody's memory, since 1976, all funding, all appropriation bills, and many authorization bills, including the Affordable Care Act and defense authorization bills, have been subjected to a limitation on the use of tax dollars for abortions, except in the case of rape and in the cases where a physician certifies the health of the mother is at stake. Well, the bill that we introduced that was passed out of Judiciary Committee unanimously and has 12 Democratic co-sponsors has a reference to an appropriation bill that had that same limitation. So the idea was that we wouldn't try to change the status quo here, we would try to maintain the status quo, which has existed for 39 years. But then some of our colleagues on the other side said, when offered an opportunity to vote on an amendment stripping that language out, they wouldn't even vote. They wanted to obstruct and filibuster this legislation instead. Well, I, for one, am more interested in getting to a solution than I am engaging in this partisan point scoring. And I believe that there are a sufficient number of members of the United States Senate who are sick and tired of the dysfunction and who don't want to be distracted by the politics but want to focus on how do we help those 100,000 victims of human sex trafficking that are estimated to exist on an annual basis. So what I would have come to the floor to do is to say, let's make this fund subject to the annual appropriations process. That will preserve the money for the victims, and it cannot be used for any other purpose. But it will be subject to the Appropriations Committee and the usual riders that have existed for 39 years. But it won't represent an expansion of the Hyde Amendment, as some of our colleagues have expressed concerns about. It would basically, again, maintain the status quo. I came to the floor yesterday, and my friend, the senator from California was here. I pointed out that not only did she co-sponsor this legislation, she voted for it in Judiciary Committee, but she now feels like so strongly, and I know that it's a matter of good faith and true conviction for her, but she feels like this is the place where we ought to fight this fight. We ought to relitigate the scope of the Hyde Amendment. And I don't think we have to do that. I'm a proudly pro-life, and I believe the Hyde Amendment represents one little island of consensus in the wars over abortion that we have. And that's why for 39 years we have had a limitation on tax dollars, and indeed the fines paid into this fund would be public dollars. They wouldn't be generated from revenue, but it's not private money. Once they're paid as a penalty into this fund, they are public dollars here under my proposal, subject to appropriation on an annual basis by the Appropriations Committee. So now the money will flow from the victims' fund through the relevant appropriation bills. It will be preserved for the victims and cannot be used for any other purpose, and all spending limitations that have routinely applied to those bills would apply to these funds as well. So the question is, Mr. President, can our friends who have been obstructing this legislation and filibustering it, can they take yes for an answer? Can they take yes for an answer? I think this will also be very revealing, because we will find out, are people actually interested in a solution, or are they trying to shut down the United States Senate and prevent us from functioning on anything? And as I've said before, if we can't get to yes on an anti-trafficking bill, heaven help us on things that are not this consensus, there is as much consensus about, and where there are genuine policy differences. But here, I believe we can do exactly, for example, what Senator Leahy, the ranking member of the Judiciary Committee, asked for on the floor on March the 10th. He said, but let's have it on things it should be on, an appropriations bill. So I would say yes to Senator Leahy. My proposal would give you what you asked for. And then the minority whip, Senator Durbin, the senator from Illinois, said on the 16th, he said, Henry Hyde authored the Hyde Amendment that said no federal funds shall be used to pay for abortion procedures except in very limited circumstances, rape, incest, life of the mother. And that has been put in appropriation bills every year without question, without challenge. That was the minority whip, Senator Durbin from Illinois. My proposal would facilitate exactly what he is arguing for. Can he say yes? Take yes for an answer. And then there's the minority leader, Senator Reid, said on the 11th, he said, I served in the House of Representatives with Henry Hyde, a very fine man. And he's had his name affixed to an anti-abortion bill, anti-abortion legislation, for almost three decades. And it's been continued year after year in appropriation bills. That's Senator Reid, the Democratic leader. So, as I pointed out, Mr. President, the thing that's perplexed me so much about all this is our Democratic friends have routinely voted for appropriation bills that contain the same restriction. When they said, well, now you're extending it to an authorization bill, I pointed out that they voted for this very similar restrictions in the Affordable Care Act and in defense authorization bills, so that argument doesn't hold water. But I'm giving them a chance to say yes, and in essence, trying to find a way to break this impasse that's existed now for the last couple of weeks. So that's the question, Mr. President. Now that we've made a proposal to them to give them what they've asked for and still preserve the 39-year limitation on the use of public dollars for abortion, can they take yes for an answer? I can't wait to hear what their response is to that proposal. Mr. President, I yield the floor.